Hello, Nether here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We are playing in the Legacy League on patch 2.6. And we have just made it to Act 4 of Cruel Difficulty. So, for this episode, of course, we're gonna head to Dried Lake and then play through the mines and basically gear up or get ready before attempting the final series of boss fights of Act 4. After which, we can continue onwards into Merciless difficulty. With a bit of luck, this is gonna be my final character ever to play through until five additional items. Yeah, that's nice. Final character that is gonna make it to Merciless. Because of course, once 3.0 hits, we are not gonna have Cruel and Merciless anymore. We will only have... As I said, we will only have one single playthrough of 10 acts. Well, for those of you who are watching this from the future, in the past, it used to be that the game only had the first 4 acts of the game. And after you completed Act 4, you would have to start over again in Act 1. Oh, pre-corrupted. I like it. But you would start over again in Act 1. And it would become another difficulty level called Cruel. Where things would be more difficult, but you got a resistance penalty. And all those lovely, lovely things. And you would play through it again. And then after you defeated Malakai on Cruel, you would go up another difficulty level to Merciless for the final playthrough. And then once you've finished Act 4, Merciless, that is the point where you could start mapping. That's of course one of those interesting things to consider. I think the player base has been growing pretty tremendously over the years, and a lot of people keep just finding the game or rediscovering the game. So it's a very decent assumption that a lot of people who will watch this video, no, not when it gets released, but let's say somewhere in the following year, because they wanna know about a Flame Blast build or something like that, they might not even know or have experienced difficulty levels. But it's one of the nice things to consider, though, that games actually they change over time. They get more interesting. So just focusing more on the add-ons than on the boss itself. A game like Path of Exile just keeps evolving. That's not how games used to be. Personally, I really enjoy it. Just trying to be a little bit cautious and defensive here. Oi! Yes. Like that. Exactly like that. Also, who ate my golems? You buggers. Okay, you just keep releasing corsairs, aren't you? Okay, I'm just gonna ignore the corsairs now and focus on this bugger. Yeah, elemental damage reflection, that's not a good match for me. I do quite some elemental damage here. But it's alright. I don't think playing reflect maps is ever going to be on my wishlist, but... No, killing the odd elemental reflect mob every once in a while, it's going to be alright. It's going to be doable. Just have to keep in mind that they hurt. Just approach it cautiously. Okay, there's a rare there, and it is not even burning. It looked like it was burning, but that was because there was a golem standing next to it. I'm starting to wonder if... Oh, for the normal fights, I'll keep plopping down my upper storms and my scorching ray totem. Because there are no tools I want to try to build a habit for, of using against bosses, things like that. But I think for most normal fights, just putting down the upper storms and then not taking out scorching ray, but just simply going for decoy totem might be better. No, decoy totem, it distracts mobs. And interestingly enough, it also groups them together. Of course, if mobs are grouped, that means I can just easily draw a nice circle around them for flame blast. So there is some synergy there. Ooh, see that one? He just went back to the totem. I like it. But for most regular foes, so you can get away with simply just putting a flame blast down and just scorching them. Most of the things in one hit. But if they're more mobile foes, then having something to just group them around is gonna be pretty nice to have. Just a quality of life feature. Okay, then cross the water again. Should be getting pretty close to the vulture. Yeah, there we are. You be burnt. Yeah, see, it was mostly dead already. I must say the minimap, it's a nice quality of life improvement, but not having no minimap is not as bad a thing as I thought it would be. I thought it would be, you know, instant win, but old map is, it's manageable, though admittedly the maps in the later acts are better than in the earlier acts. That's also fun, one thing to keep in mind. It's going through Act 1 Merciless again. That's probably going to be the true test for whether I like the... whether the old minimap is actually truly as horrid as it could be at times. Okay, and there we are, nearly at town. Oh. So it's funny that the big shadow still passes over even though the boss is dead. It's one of those interesting random terrain decorations that I'm not entirely sure if they mean to imply that there might be more of the large vultures, or whether it's just a misplaced location for the shadow. You there. Let me bend your ear for Hello. Let's see you knock me on my arse. I actually just put down the combat thing, and then kablooey, and another kablooey, and wait, you drank a flask. That's almost like you're a player. Yeah, there you go. And that was a nice stop before town. Town doesn't really have a lot to offer to us, so what we can do is just sell stuff and move forward again. Ah, yeah, we got the Wormscale Compots as a drop. It's all just rare stuff, doesn't really matter. And these were Worm Sign. I think I found these in the beta as well a couple days ago. Interesting if you're using Endurance Charges and like Rampage. There's another Rampage themed set of gloves that I personally liked better. Something with Shadows? Name escapes me right now. Not really all that important. Go where you are needed. Well, I've had a decent amount of fun with that. So let's double check. Yep, we are fully stoned up and ready to go. Okay. The objective. Murder and Burval. Yeah, we now have a Rampage active. There's a Leakstone mechanic, and we have Beyond. So lots of lovely things here. Also, maybe I should not be too close to enemies when they try to murder me. It's rather unhealthy. Oh, demons. Okay. That worked. Here for Rampage, the first couple of stacks are interesting, but well, pushing past more than 50 kills never really feels that meaningful. Though it is fun to just have a streak of like 300 or so kills going on. I think that's the highest I managed to get in Dried Lake. And then enemies were just gone. Hello there, I wanna be a Fiji. Oh, yes, I did manage to actually get you in a circle. Lovely. Okay, Artisan Strongbox. Boxes are nice. Boxes have a chance of getting extra currency, but I think in this case, we wanna see if we can get some additional demons. Okay. No extra monster spawns, let's just go with 5 additional items then. Just settle for it. It'll be right. Yay! More whetstones than you can shake a stick at. Scarring. Level is this actually? 55. Okay, so I'm one level underleveled. So killing more things, definitely useful. X4, generally not an area where you want to be too far underleveled. Especially not once we start adding ghosts to the mix. Got some demons. So far, I have to say, golems are holding up pretty well. So the primeval jewel thing that we found, it's doing its thing. It's keeping our golem safe. Okay. And that is a new kind of spirit shield, I think. Blazewood. I don't remember seeing it before. Well, new to me, not new to the game. And indeed, it's level 56 version, so that's even one level above the area. That's always nice. Always a question of where a Vol is gonna end up being, whether he's gonna be somewhere near the bottom over here, or whether he's all gonna be all the way on the left side of the map. But, 50-50, I think. Oh, Elemental Reflect. That's always fun. Yeah. You. Please die. Yeah, thank you. Alright, and we found Vol. That's good. We got the easy layout this time. Right, maybe just step sideways here, and then blast you a couple more times. He's dying. Help him a little bit more. Yes. Ooh, wow.
Thaumaturgy just keeps getting the better of you, doesn't it?
I got excited and then I realized it's just the overflowing chalice. It's, I don't like this flask. It has no inherent effects. Well, it has consecrated ground. It has increased damage, sure. But all it does is just buff the recharge rate of other flasks. So now if you're playing a piano flask build or something, then sure, fine, you're sacrificing one slot to make the other four more useful, but yeah, never really appealed to me. Okay, with that, let's go back, because a vol was all we cared about. It's just more in the box. And let's see, double check, yes. Time to move forward. And recast our golems, because no, they were slowly getting frazzled a little bit. And they're more sturdy now, but they do still have some wear and tear damage, and there's no life regen on them. Because I haven't put any life regen on them. That's no, for a dedicated minion build, having just a couple percent of life regen on your minions is just so nice for just keeping them alive. Come on, yes. Golems are at least nice because they're rather, relatively slow. So it just gives you a lot of time to just charge up your flame blast and just blast them to bits. Turn them into glass. Okay, maybe I shouldn't be. Oh, pike rivet. Could say, maybe I shouldn't be too close to them in melee range. Okay, get another demon spawn and level up. I approve. So, 56 area. That's right. Oh, getting way too much more damage there than I would like to. Come on, man. Stop trying to murder me. That's really, really not simple. Okay, now we go there. Move and shoot, move and shoot. Oh, and a reflect. There we are. Okay, golem please. Thank you. It's so nice when they give you a plus one thing to kill. Okay, one ghost. You're heading the wrong way, dude. It's clear there. There's nothing for you to possess, really. Yeah, ghosts. Pretty cool. Getting closer to leveling up here. That's nice. That's gonna be a pretty nice bonus to our life. Of course, we're gonna grab Constitution, the heart of the Scion, a life wheel. With essence, sure. And there we are, leveled up. Ooh, flame blast went up. That is nice as well. Ah, yeah. Average damage is just so weird. Okay, nearly gained. So we actually gained 200 life for just one single skill point. That is a nice investment. Definitely hope that by the least early Merciless would be nice if we can surpass 3000 life. So it's nice to just at least have a comfortable amount of life for situations like this when you're standing in the middle of caustic clouds and things like that. Energy shield is, after all, pretty flimsy defense right now. Gonna buff it, of course, but that's not really the focus just yet.
I think it likes me.
Okay, and boom, there we are. Yeah, top check the leak stones. Yes, we need another one. We have gonna have an ambush for the next one. More strong boxes, that's always good. Strong boxes and beyond, they mix very well. Rampage, yeah, not so much. Then again, Rampage doesn't really mix all that great with most things, except if you're playing a fast clear speed build. But no, for a slower play like me, Rampage, it's nice every once in a while to get the explosion in the middle of a fight, but that's kind of the extent of it. Building up a very, very long streaks is a bit more difficult for me. Okay, let's take a step back here, because there is some damage that gets tossed my way. Rapidly clicking it feels like a bit of a game of whack-a-mole. Just click 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 click. Surprisingly effective as well, given that most mobs don't really have that much health yet. Right. Once set on fire, things die. And there we have Hammerstorm. Just line things up. Yep, we got your curse, makes it easier to burn him. A flammability, it's a nice curse. No, it lowers resistances, but also increases the chance to ignite. And well, especially in 2.6, ignite is pretty darn potent. 3.0, you're gonna have to focus on it. But at least another free skill point is waiting for us. Next up is going to be a chance to find the way down. Let's see, 55. I think, wasn't the harvest that was actually level 60? Or did we just end up shy of 60? It doesn't really matter, we'll figure it out soon enough. Freeze been activated, 5 additional items. So let's just drink and freeze before we head in. It works pretty well. You can use the flame blast to shoot around corners by just casting at the corner and then making the area of the flame blast just expand beyond the corner. So some situations it might help you shoot at things that can't shoot back. Then again, if the AI puts in a little bit of effort, then of course they're gonna reposition if they're getting shot at without being able to shoot back. Well, sometimes you get lucky. Path of Exile has never really been known for its stellar AI. Just ask any experienced summoner. I think they often have good things to say about the AI. And there we are, the crystal veins. Okay, and we did not exhaust them, but next level gonna burn through two stones again. But that's gonna be for the next time. We're now 25 minutes in. So well, this first part playthrough, it always an hour or half an hour. Sometimes if I'm a little more lucky in finding some distracting things like corrupted side areas, it might take a little longer. The other hand, of course, we haven't completed the mines yet. So there is still plenty of opportunity for distractions. And often these mines, they do get corrupted side areas relatively frequently. Or it might not even be that you get them relatively frequently, but it's just that you see them more often because you just bump into them. Haha, hey! Speaking of, 10% elemental reflect. This is going to be an interesting thing to be cautious about blowing things up, because elemental reflect, it's going to hurt. Means that even just charging up for small attacks, it's going to backfire. And also because we will be taking damage, even for just attacking, not even for taking damage. Energy shield recharge is... it's gonna get delayed quite a bit during the fight. On the other hand, hey, we got Mob Storms, we got a Totem. They do pretty decent damage together. And groups of mobs, of course, but with all the reflected, can do quite some damage. So the max hit is about a third of my energy shield. That's alright. That's pretty alright. It's against the Grooks. That's where a charged... Okay. I really have to stop underscoring what I'm saying with live examples, because that is gonna get me killed one of these days. Because without Mind Over Matter, I would have been dead here. Just... shooting at so many targets at the same time, the damage stacks and it hurts a lot. In that regard, I think it's better to play an armor-based physical build in a physical reflect map. Because if you're hitting a lot of mobs, then at least you're getting little bits of damage back at you and your armor is just gonna nullify most of it. Just small bits, little amount of targets, and then we're gonna do just fine here. Just click them. Whack them all, not burn them in one single hit. Okay. Ah, did it. I think we're getting close to the boss room. Again, though, the turrets can deal most of the damage against regular mobs. It's a decent way to cheese reflect, actually. I just put a totem, put a turret on it, or a totem, or whatever you want to call it. I suppose their name is actually a totem, not a turret. Oh, Rogue Exile, the Enterak. Calxifer, okay, yeah, you. Okay, Sentinel, let's just clean house a little bit. Just draw them out and then just murder them one by one. Okay, you, you. Yeah, that's the... Was the guy that keeps flicker striking around, right? Calxifer. Just grab the tricorn. Now build like this, you do burn through quite a bunch of orbs of alteration, just rerolling your blue items. So selling items at every opportunity you can works for just allowing you to reroll new stuff. Let's actually empty our pockets, grab a couple more items out of the loot, and then push forward. Right, I think I just dumped a leak stone. That might not be the best of ideas. Exactly like that. Okay, anything that is potentially useful? Foul lightning trap. Ah, I already have one. But would have been a nice find if I still needed one. Then you don't have to make one yourself. But it's a nice property though of the foul gems that you can both make and find them. Okay, kill stuff. Sure, fine. Die. Just some of those light chaos based attacks. Having a little bit of life regen is enough to just basically ignore the chaos portion of the damage. It's if you're not regenerating any life, that's where it does start to add up and you keep sipping life flask and things like that. Okay, there's no magic item. Yeah, here we have to be wary of demons if I remember correctly. So no reflect, but there's demons. Ooh, and a rampage. And yep, our buddy. The Burning Man. Probably is pretty resistant to fire, but the lead up to the explosion is large enough. Right, you're gonna be right. Oh, let's get out of there. That was a little too crowded for my taste. Could be interesting if there would be a flame blast counterpart to lightning warp. Or maybe if lightning warp could be a support gem, because then you could channel flame blast and then upon release you would teleport into the location of the flame blast and also do a perform a flame blast at the location where you left off. That would be very nice for just leaving a area where you're surrounded by pesky enemies, and then you have a movement skill that you can actually use as an attack skill. Would be nice. So it would probably be too efficient, but it's fun to speculate. And I don't think I have to ID this, because we know this is greed, essence of greed. And it is a tit. Okay, so Burning Man's dead, essence is grabbed. And next stop is gonna be the waypoint. Oh, there's a reflector in there. Spotted that one too late. Okay, there you are. Ton to get around. Okay. Okay, so when we entered this area, I was talking about, like, I was making pretty good progress. And, well, case in point, we got a corrupted area, and now it seems to be pretty difficult to actually find where we have to be. No. Level can only be so large, so chances of finding it do increase with every step we take. And this looks like it's... yes, exactly. So, okay, if we could have gone to the sides there, we could have found it a little earlier, but not by much. So we have a Lady Adiala over there. Then we can get another skill point from Tosuni, which of course is gonna go towards more life. Just increasing that accidental suicide by reflect safety buffer or something along those lines. Because I have to say it does make me a little nervous. But I know myself. I always do the things I shouldn't be doing. And having a little bit more life and such does protect you against silly things. But with that said, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you again next time when we go after King Kong. Bye bye.